Welcome, Broodlings, to another Let's Play, Stasis, released in 2015 by the Brotherhood. It was a Kickstarter-funded project, though I was not aware of the Kickstarter. I was not even aware of the game until it was released. This is an isometric sci-fi, science fiction, horror adventure game. Now, I know a lot of you have heard me say that I can't play horror games, but I can play an isometric adventure horror game. So, sci-fi horror stasis, yes. At least I hope so, that I can handle this. Something like Dead Space, definitely no. So, we just got up. Oh, you know, let me start this over. Because I was testing things. I can skip this. I'm not familiar with this quote. Without a family, man, alone in the world, trembles with the cold. I'm going to be skipping the long spaceship tugging another spaceship, apparently. And I think that's where, see that in my intro. I think that's where you'll see our protagonist is located. Let's just... Here we go. No, he's not feeling very well. Easy there, buddy. Now...
Welcome to the Game Corporation Stasis Plug Suit.
Plug Suit.
Please hold still while your biometric scans are completed. Arrhythmia. Multiple fractures along ribs 3, 5, 11, and 14.
Not good.
Extreme muscle atrophy. Danger of heart failure. Danger of pneumothorax. Seek immediate medical attention.
I don't know what pneumothorax
medical
is.
Medical data storage is damaged. Formatting quantum storage device. Plug suit quantum storage device is ready for physical record storage.
I'm glad it's ready. A smeared pool of some dark, sticky, congealed substance. Probably blood. I read all the things, just so you know. So if you don't like somebody who reads all the things, sorry. I guess this isn't the series for you. I'm playing this blind, so... Beyond a few things in this room, I really haven't done anything. I've walked out of the room just to test, like, the audio levels and stuff. I really haven't messed with anything in here. I've just seen there's, you know, some things we can interact with and some things we can look at, read stuff, and that's about it. Now, I think that's all I have to say. Okay. So I'm going to read all the stuff, I'm going to listen to all the stuff, and I play slowly and deliberately, trying to, because you really got to pay attention, especially in a game like this. Oh, I just finished playing Adrift. That's what I was thinking of. Another thing where a suit talks to you, or at least I think it's the suit talking to me, or it's the AI talking to the suit, I don't know. But in any case, yeah. Was a little more friendly in Adrift than here. The voice sounds almost menacing, the way it talks to you. I'm sure that's intended. Steam! The humid steam gives off a sickly sweet smell as it rises from the glass tube. Ooh. Let me see, we're fluid. Can I mess with it? No? Mess with the fluid? Terminal. This terminal appears to be offline.
This isn't my ship.
Alright, so this isn't his ship. So we're towing a ship that he used to be on? He was transferred from one ship to another. I don't even know. Subject, Maracheck J. Batch number, stuff, status, cryostasis interrupted. Inside the glass tube, a corpse hangs like a grotesque puppet. Tangled in the pipes and wires that had once provided life, it is now no more than a lifeless husk. So I can't really interact with this stuff. The room is still and frigid, but the warmth radiates from the machinery. A horrifying face is pressed against the glass of this pod, its skin pulled taut over its bones. Okay, so I guess this one... This was my wait. So this is me. I am J. Maracheck. And this was Anderson S. Cryo tube malfunction. Please see maintenance.
My heart.
Okay.
Please see immediate medical attention.
Yeah, we had no idea. You know, that's what we should do. So he's having trouble with his heart. His muscles are atrophied because he's... It looks like we're in some kind of cryostasis, right? So that's normal. The heart problems, I don't think would be normal. He's got some other issues. He's got broken ribs, so this thing crashed, I suppose, or something. So who's... I can't make out what they're saying. Terminal is offline.
Oh God.
Elevated moral activity can be detrimental to your current state of health.
Oh boy.
Please stay calm.
Stay calm. Okay, do I know that person? The contorted body inside this pod is suspended in a thick amber fluid that distorts its features. So, we didn't react like that to this person, but to that we did. Which makes me think we might know that person. Jackson P. Crowd 2 malfunction, etc. Alright. Operator's chair. The well-worn leather of the chair is cracked, showing its age. The only sound in this room is the hiss of static from the monitors. Their flickering light illuminates the leather chair, the cracks in its surface evident, even beneath the shroud of dust that covers it. Alright, so we've been left alone for quite a while. And then things started to fall apart, or we crashed or something. We need medical attention, so can we get that here? And there was also this thing that moves around, turns. Makes me think we can, like, do something with this, right? But no. And there's no kind of... No, there's no, like, controls. How do I... Alright. Now this door will open, but I'm not sure if we're supposed to be going that way. Does this room end here? What does that say? John. Oh, look at myself. I am John. Okay, we also have this up here. Oh, it's just, okay. Game saves. Okay, I guess we're going through the door. No, this is just looking at... That's an eye. Okay, that's an eye. So we can't really interface with anything. This... we can interface with... has a different little arrow icon. The dust of ages.
Increased heart rate detected. Automated medical care systems are non-functional.
Well, that's great.
Please seek medical attention.
I'm trying.
Yeah. This is not our ship. We don't know our way around here. Where's my cursor? Okay, when I get to the edge of this screen, it seems to, act as an alt tab out. The shadows from a slowly spinning fan move lazily across the floor grates. Yes, they do. Is this something I can't go? So dark, can't tell. Thought that might have been a room. What? What? What does that noise mean? The fans spin slowly, circulating air throughout the through the dark, damp chamber.
Hello.
Infirmary.
Please. Is anyone there?
I'd say no. So, the stuff's offline, Bloodstain, but we might be able to get it online, and then we can get ourselves fixed up. Dried blood streaks the floor in a wide swath, as if someone had been dragged or slowly crawled away. It's hard to tell whether it came from or went toward the infirmary door. Yeah, I wonder. Dried blood trails downward from the countertop. The chairs sit vacant, the leather split with wear along the seams and rounded edges. Corroded padding protrudes from tears in the fabric. Holographic projector. The words holotron projector are embossed in metal on this piece of machinery, but the screen is smashed and it looks beyond repair. Product check-in terminal. A blinking readout on the screen reads product storage check-in system.
At least the computer's working.
Okay, product storage checklist. Oh, look at that. So here's me, Maracheck. Blood type O positive. Male, age 38. Stasis.
Oxygen. Nitrogen storage requires further maintenance and fall isolation.
I don't know what that's saying. Stasis pod acquired. Personal transport ship intercepted en route to Titan Station Espenza. One of three stasis pods. I was on a personal transport ship, and it was intercepted. That's it, I guess, huh? Anderson. O negative, male, 36. Mining transport orbiting Titan, part of a long-term terraforming operation. One of 17 stasis pods reserved for a Project Kitchen Knife? What the hell is that? P. Jackson. Peters must have been the one that he reacted to. Because we saw Anderson and we saw Maracheck, but we Anderson, Jackson, Maracheck. Not Peters, that one wasn't working. Okay, he's young, AB positive. Male, age 19. Stasis pod acquired. Escape pod from down transport between Earth and Mars. One of four stasis pods. So they've been This is an escape pod. Some mining transport orbiting. And I was intercepted. So why are they grabbing these pods? Is there something wrong with these pods? Or are they collecting us and doing away with the others? Peters is also male. A negative. Age 46. Returning luxury transport. All hands lost one of 12 stasis pods. Okay, I'm not sure if we actually know this person then. I thought it might have been his wife or something. Product storage notifications. Notice. In addition to Dr. Essex, we are happy to welcome Sarah Salvatore, the new head nurse of product storage. It was a sad day when Nurse Daniels left us for greener pastures, and she will be missed. Notice, as our cloning facility has been deemed too costly, we are happy to note that product storage has now been upgraded to a level 6 facility. We are now the number one supplier of human specimens to the entire facility. Human specimens. After the unfortunate incident in product storage 2, we'll be undergoing... Okay, don't do that. After the unfortunate incident in product storage 2, do you hear me? We will be undergoing regular upgrades and maintenance. I know, it's so frightening. Starting with a new lockdown and security system. Thank you for your hard work and dedication. Ah! And notice, 2 weeks ago, a forced security lockdown occurred in product storages 2 and 3. Kane Corporation has terminated operations on both floors until a cleanup crew can evaluate the situation. We regret to report that 17 crew deaths and the expiration of 12 unopened products occurred due to the emergency venting procedures. 12 unopened products? Is that when I was an unopened product? Because I don't think I was part of the crew, right? You really type on these keys? Looks like an old typewriter. Well, that was fun, including a little scream. Oh, there's a door going... That's a door there, alright. This thing rolled out. Okay, look at that. Now, there's no... tab? No. As far as I know, there's no key for selectables. And there's no, like, toggle run or anything like that. I don't think he can run in his condition anyway. Oh boy, I don't think we should go over there. Yeah, going this way. Okay. Same with that chair. The terminal lies dormant, its readout blank. I don't know what it's saying. Active multiple specimens or something like that? A bank of static-filled monitors lines the walls, their displays all emitting the same dim, distorted image. Of what? Alright, so I guess there's nothing else to look at. I'm just looking around. I got B1, B2. Just looking around because I really heard, like... I read a few spoiler-free reviews that say that you really have to look for items. Powered down robotic arm. A useless robotic arm sits clamped to the desk. I can't take that. Well, it's clamped to the desk, right? So in my current state, I don't think I can wrench that through. Let's go to the infirmary. Why are you walking this way? They didn't mention pathing issues. The infirmary. Crib. Light passes through the bars, casting stark shadows on the walls behind. A tangle of long discarded and moldering bed linen lies in this infant crib. Why would there be a crib? A stripped down hospital bed sits in the corner, its side rails bent outward, and the head and foot sections broken as if by tremendous force. Dark stains smear the bars, but it is otherwise empty. Several hastily discarded infirmary ward screens. Okay.
Groomlake Infirmary is closed until further notice. Incorporation accepts no responsibility for death.
What's that? I couldn't understand you. So legally speaking, that bear no weight. That will bear no weight in a court of inquiry. So maybe we can get this stuff online, and I guess rather painfully fix ourselves. Now, Kane Corporation, which is interesting. Now I know there's a follow-up game to this that's actually free on Steam. As I speak right now, it is free. I think it's been released free, and for the foreseeable future will be free. So I'll be playing that next, most probably. That's one's going to be a lot shorter than this one. Like 3 or 4 hours from what I hear. This one's more like 10 hours. But I'm reading stuff, so probably be more like 15 for me. Mechanical ventilator. The ventilator sits motionless and unable to sustain life. That's not very encouraging. An abandoned wheelchair with crumbling leather armrests. The mechanical ventilator stands motionless. An attached tracheotomy tube is encrusted with a greenish-brown substance that dried up long ago. Greenish-brown? So it would be blood then. Breaker box. This appears to be an electrical distribution panel for the infirmary power grid. It has numerous circuit breakers for powering systems in the infirmary. That is not English. Alright, well, we're gonna need a thing to put into it, aren't we? Or do I just mess around, or do I just press things and it turns on? Robotic surgeon. Oh, that's gonna be very painful, isn't it?
Robotic surgeon active.
Oh boy. Docmate scanner. Oh. What did I do?
Emergency life support active.
So I have emergency life support. Okay, so wait.
Docmate scanner active.
Okay. So this should be... We need arrows here. This is power. That's robotic surgeon. That's life support. That's Docmate scanner. Wait. Oh boy. Sounds so friendly. The darkness congeals into fearsome shapes in the gap between the bed and the wall. The unwrinkled linen smells faintly of antiseptic. A number of dark stains cover the sheets. I really like the flavor text here. The different flavor text for like each bed, each crib, each thing. I like it. Several pieces of surgical equipment have been left out on the side tray table. They're corroded and caked in dry blood. Organic waste bin. The pungent stench of decomposition wafts from the bin marked organic waste. The surgical waste bin appears to be clean and empty. The peeling label on the side of the empty bin reads excess surgical equipment only. This bin stands empty. See? They even have a different... Even though that one's empty and that one's empty, they have a different description for each. Not, like, really important, but I like things like that. This is the Docmate scanner. Docmate scanner terminal. Okay, so we activate there, and then we walk in there, right? What is he saying, and who is he, and where is that coming from? Do not cross line when surgery is in progress. The arm for the automated robot surgeon is retracted. The access terminal is inactive. It's display block. Well, I'm going to mess with that at some point. It's off now because I wanted the power on. This equipment provides a medical diagnosis of a specimen through a non-invasive scanning procedure. Treatment is administered through a nanite solution drug cocktail that is delivered intravenously. Alright, so first things first, we gotta fix ourselves and then figure out where the hell we are and what the hell to do with anything. Docmate scanner terminals. The computer terminals are covered in a sticky veil of cobwebs and dust, indicating they have not been used in a long time. Don't I need to mess with the terminal first? He's just slowly walking over.
Docmate scanner active.
Oh, I'm afraid.
Multiple injuries detected. Emergency medical kit created.
Created.
The night solution, anticoagulant, and morphine combination suggested.
Why do we not?
Thank you for using Docmate Systems. Have a nice day.
Have a nice day. Anticoagulant. Why do I not want my blood to coagulate? I don't want like a blood clot or something like that in my heart? Something like that? Emergency medical kit drawer. The emergency medical kit stands, or sits rather, on the glowing slab, automatically filled with the required dosage of medication. Oh boy. I'm sure this is going to be incredibly painful. But if I live, that's a plus, right? I can stop clutching my chest as I walk. Maybe I can actually get dressed at some point. That would be wonderful. Is it an inventory or something? Is there a key for inventory? Do I go back in here now that I have that? Let's go back in here and see. I don't know that we have something, a way to access inventory. Well, he won't go in now. Did he automatically use it? Figured it would be painful as hell. Every game I know has I for inventory. Enter. Shrine keys here. Cause that appeared, looked like we could like choose something, right? They were like two things on a little wheel. Wow. Watch, there's like a manual or something I didn't read. Yeah, I pressed a whole bunch of stuff. Okay. Alright, I give up. Let's...
Warning. John Maracheck. Records indicate you are under medical lockdown. Please report to your physician immediately.
Medical lockdown. Okay. Oh, I can't mess with the breakers anymore? What's this? Oh, wait. Oh, my inventory can be reached down here. And here I thought it was like some other part of the room. Got it. Okay. Docmate systems mixture. Empty hybridemic syringe. The voice is talking again. Right in his butt. Right in the butt crack right there. John, take your medicine, John. Do I put it here? I figured I'd just click it on John. Wait, I guess when it says John? Oh, okay.
Deep breath.
I can't insert it in his butt crack.
But Dad, Sandy said that if you have bad dreams and you can't wake up that, you'll be stuck in them forever.
Well, I'll have a good talk to Sandy's parents.
But is it true?
Becca, don't worry, you won't have any dreams for the entire trip. But if you do, just squeeze Teddy, and I promise they'll go away. Now legs up, lay down. There you go.
Sweet dreams, my girl.
No! Wait, sing it. Sing the song.
John, looks like we have a song to sing. Go to sleep, my baby girl, in your warm bed. Soon you will rise again. So drift away, sleepy head. Dream of us and you will see. Monsters can't harm you or me. Close your eyes again and worry no more. Stars and the moons, they will pass us by soon. A new day will surely be upon you and me. So go to sleep, my baby girl, in your warm bed. Soon you will
again. So drift away, sleepy head.
You know, you could have just told her that we're gonna have so many drugs in our system that we'll barely remember our own names.
Yeah. Somehow squeezing Teddy seemed a little more comforting than you'll be in a drug-induced coma.
Yeah.
We are almost done here. Do I get a Teddy?
You get a hug.
Wish you gotta flap your arms around like that.
Rebecca?
It doesn't look that good.
My wife. My child. I need to find someone. I need to get out of here.
Let me guess. They didn't survive.
Vital medical functions have been restored to benchmark levels.
Levels. Wow. Kind of creepy. Kind of sad already. I think this is a good spot to cut it off. So thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.